Hi, my name is Kasper Moth-Poulsen. I'm a professor in nanomaterials chemistry at Chalmers University of Technology in Gothenburg, Sweden. Today, I would like to talk about how we work in my research group, how we take research projects from the idea phase through initial testing to refinement and final publication and sharing of the information to the rest of the world. So the important things about research, one of the important elements is, of course, quality, but it's also being early on or ideally first in the world with the new projects we are building. So in this context, it's important to think about the structure and how we work with our projects. So I normally divide the project into four different stages. The first stage, I call it idea phase. In this this phase, we generate the ideas, we refine them, and then we, as soon as possible, go into an initial testing phase. In the testing phase, it's about doing the experiments as simple as possible in order to draw conclusions around, are this a good project? Is this going to work? Is this crazy idea possible at all? So typically, we test several projects here. And the principle of working is to do every experiment as poorly as possible. That means that we just have to design a simple experiment that tells us, is this good or bad? Since there's a high risk of failure, we often test many projects here, and then we pick the best ones. Then we take into the refinement phase. In the refinement phase, we do all the check experiments. We make several examples of the same chemical reaction. We do all the finer experiments. Since this is much more time consuming, we can only take a few projects there. So maybe we have each student have one, maybe two projects in the refinement phase. And this is also where to accelerate to the finish line, that you can get help from your colleagues. It's here you can get your, maybe a visiting student to help you in the extra experiments and get everything nice and ready for the publication. So in the end, we write it up. And then we publish. So this is more or less how most people would do it, I would say, going from idea, testing, refining, and writing. The problem here is that this process takes typically 24 to 36 months. And we like to be first with our projects. So we need to look into how we can optimize the process and make this as strong and powerful and efficient as possible. So if we start with the idea phase, it's very important that we get the right ideas early on. It's so that most people today, all the researchers in the world, have access to more or less the same information. So often people get sort of the same ideas at the same time. So it's very important that we start the clock of this movement from idea to the finish line as early as possible. So in order to do that, we need to have a good idea of the research front. If we look at, if we imagine border here, this is all known literature and experiment and knowledge in the world about a certain topic, then our research project should take us out here in the unknown, beyond the state of the art. So this is, of course, a not well-defined border. So we need to read literature. We need to follow what is going on, maybe at conferences. Maybe we can get a feeling about how people think and what they're working on by following Twitter, Chem Archive, or other similar things where things come out early on. So this combination of the social media, the classical media, conferences, and literature would give us, ideally, a very good view on what is state of the art and how we can generate new projects that are beyond state of the art. Then, of course, the testing phase, it's about doing as many tests and transforming the ideas into a viable experiment as fast as possible. So here, test a lot, do simple experiments. In the refinement phase, it's about doing the refinement. Now we know that it's likely going to work, but it has to be nice, it has to be well done. Here it's often quite work intensive, so often try to get help from others, and maybe other group members could help you in your side project. Then the writing phase, some people started after they have refined all the experiment. I would argue that it's smarter to move the writing down here, because at the refinement stage, we know that this project is likely going to work. So we can just as well start to write early on. This will also give us a better focus on our refinement phase, because we will identify the needed figures, the needed argument, the needed test experiment. So there can be a very good interaction between the writing and the refinement. So finally, we have made all our experiments, we have refined it, we are ready to publish. And we send it to our favorite journal, and it gets published. But then it's about creating impact, about making people read the papers. So here, we want to reach our audience. It could be our friends in the chemistry world. So we go to conferences. We share with them on the social media, like Twitter, LinkedIn. We go to the classical media with press releases. Or maybe we even write small feature articles or make small videos about our work in order to amplify all the hard work we've done over here. So this can be for a PhD student or postdoc or even for a professor. This is a quite stressful thing to know that it's a race and other people likely got the idea more or less at the same time as you, and they might beat you in the race and come out on the other end before you. So the way to think about this is that if we do our work well, we will make sure that we have good ideas that are made very early on based on the newest knowledge. We work efficiently in the testing and selection of projects and refine it with the help of others in the fastest possible way. Then we can sleep well at night, we can take it easy, because we know we're going to work very fast and efficiently. And sometimes we will be first, sometimes others, but in general, we are moving forward as fast as possible. This is my small advice or thoughts about research projects and how to execute them. Thank you for listening in.